Hello friends, this is Yogesh Nagvenkar here from Heritage Connect. Welcome to another episode wherein we will be going to a very, very historic place, and that is Sao Estevao Fort. We are at the Tolto Ferry now, where it will be crossing across from the Gauji Ferry Joint to the Sao Estevao Ferry Point. We have reached the destination. We are at Sao Estevao, Saint Estevem also it is called as, Sao Estevao Fort in Tiswadi Taluka. This place is also called as Ilhas. Ilhas means island in Portuguese, which is surrounded on all the three sides by the waterfronts of River Mandovi. Let's go and explore this fort. The history of this fort goes back to the 16th century, where the Portuguese decided to build this fort on the exact centric location, which could have the visualization of three different places. One was the Dissoli, wherein the enemies who were coming from the River Mandovi could be seen across from here. One was the Diwar Island, which could be kept a watch upon, and one was the capital of the Portuguese Empire, that was Old Goa. This fort came under the major focus during the heavy turbulence between the Maratha and the Portuguese Empire. On the 24th of December 1683, the Maratha army under the leadership of Sambhaji Maharaj, who was the son of Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj, took over this particular fort in a midnight. Only 40 of soldiers took up their ladders, positioned on this fortress, and they climbed up. And then when they climbed up in this particular fort, there were only two Portuguese soldiers guarding this place, out of which one was an old guy and one was a young soldier. Both of them were killed and the Maratha took over this fort as theirs. The land that we see across the River Mandovi is the Dissoli Prant, that the Portuguese used to call it a Bicholi Taluka, as we still know it today. And the land this side was the Portuguese territory. When the Marathas attacked this particular fort in the midnight with 40 of their soldiers, the first thing that they did was they lit the cannon, and that is how the other 300 soldiers of the Maratha came over and they took over this overall fortress. This really alarmed the Viceroy of the Portuguese, Conde de Alvor, and he, along with his fleet of soldiers and the ships, came across from Dauji to this island, and that is where he, along with his captain, Captain Rodrigo da Costa, came across with the soldiers early morning at around 7 a.m. The Marathas were very, very sharp, and they were very skilled guerrilla warfare. They came to know about this move by the Portuguese, and as the Portuguese soldiers approached the fort, That is where the Marathas started attacking them with stones, swords, and even guns. Let me tell you, guns were used during that era by the Marathas as well as the Portuguese Empire. That is what turned the whole synopsis of this war. The war was so ferocious on this island and in this fort that in this particular war, Sambhaji went so aggressive on this Conde Alvor, the viceroy of the Portuguese, that he almost injured Conde Alvor while he was escaping from this land. And even the general who was Captain Rodrigo de Costa also got very, very severely injured in this battle. Many soldiers had to flee away, and that is where many of the Portuguese soldiers had to die either in the river and across this fort also. The fate was such that the Marathas won the fort and they took over the territory that was the São Estevão, as we call it today, San Esteban. This fort was built with laterite stones. We might have seen in the last video also in Goa Velia, when in this Gopakapatnam, the fort was majorly built with this particular kind of stones, laterite stones, because these were the abundantly available stones in this place that was Goa. So as we see, the structure that we see is a restored structure. This fort at one point of time was in a dilapidated ruins. Today it has been restored very well by the archives and archaeology department. This was basically the place where the soldiers or maybe the general of the fort used to rest. And it was also a storehouse for the weaponry and the artillery that the Portuguese had. Friends, we finally end our journey of the São Estevão Fort here. If you have Goa on your wish list, you definitely need to visit this beautiful place, which is surrounded by beautiful greenery and of course a lot of history and heritage value. If you like our videos, please press the like button and also the subscribe button, and please press the bell notification as you'll get updates about our next videos. This is Yogesh Nagvekar here, taking a leave. Goodbye.